Hey, what's up everybody? Too Tall Toby here, and welcome back to another Onshape Quick Tip, where today I'm going to talk to you about the mirror command in Onshape. Now, this is something that I found to be very confusing as a SolidWorks user coming into Onshape, because I didn't realize that Onshape defaults to mirror the entire part. Let me show you what I mean by that. I go into Onshape, I've got this model. The model is asymmetric. It's got this little notch here in the corner. And what I want to do is just mirror this vertical wall and this fillet down here. So basically three features that I want to mirror, but not the entire part because the part is asymmetric. So I go into Onshape and I click the mirror command up here at the main toolbar. And when I go to the mirror command, it says here, entities to mirror. Okay, well that seems pretty straightforward. I'll pick this vertical wall and I'll pick this, pick the vertical wall and I'm not really getting what I was expecting there. I thought maybe here in the entities to mirror, it would say vertical wall, fillet. Instead, it's just showing part one. It is asking me for a mirror plane now. So let me pick the mirror plane, the front plane. And okay, the preview looks good here, but not down here. This is kind of weird. It's like the corner is mirroring over. Let's hit the green check mark and see what happens. So it's really not quite what I wanted. And this gets back to what I said at the intro of this quick tip, which is that when you're doing a mirror in Onshape, the default functionality is going to be essentially a mirror all. So for example, if I wanted to mirror this whole thing across this face, I could say this is my mirror plane and I want to pick the whole part and the whole part is going to get mirrored. You're defaulted into using what's called a mirror all command or mirror part command. And so we can see here that if I right mouse button on that mirror feature that I created a moment ago, and I look at the very top of this dialog box, there's actually a flyout menu here for mirror part. And this is what I was missing as a SolidWorks user. I didn't realize that this is where I could select part mirror, feature mirror, or face mirror. In SolidWorks, we have bodies to mirror, features to mirror, and faces to mirror, which is kind of the equivocal from the other software. So this was the trick that I was missing. Let me know down in the comments if you ran into the same thing when you were first getting started with Onshape. But for me, what I need to do here is I need to change this to feature mirror. And once I change it to feature mirror, now it becomes very intuitive. I can pick this face here of the vertical extrusion. I can pick this face here of the fillet, and I can pick this face here of the fillet. Everything looks good. I can hit the green check mark. And that is exactly what I wanted from that feature. So like I said, let me know down in the comments if you ran into something similar when you were first getting started with Onshape, or if you are getting started with Onshape, let me know if that helped you get out of a jam. And of course, if you're enjoying the series, be sure to like, be sure to subscribe, and be sure to come back for the next episode.